Margaret, we'll see you again in just a bit. By the way, Claudette took many people in Florida by surprise, but they were thankful that the storm didn't pack more of a powerful punch. WDSU reporter Travers Mackel was in Pensacola Beach, Florida, and shows us the storm's impact on the Gulf Coast.
Claudette came ashore about 1 a.m., about an hour from here in Fort Walton Beach. It didn't pack much of a punch for Pensacola Beach until several hours later. Take a look out there. You can see the chop and the hard winds picking up out there in the Gulf of Mexico. A lot of surfers came out to ride these waves, but then it got too dangerous for them, so they had to go in. Nonetheless, emergency leaders using the age-old cliche that they definitely dodged a bullet when it came to this storm. The surfers were out in full force early Monday morning on Pensacola Beach, taking a ride on the high waves caused by Claudette.
Surfed really good from the storm that came in yesterday, and it's been flat for most of the summer, so this is the first real surf we've had in about 3 months.
No mandatory or voluntary evacuations along the Florida coast, but pretty much everyone keeping a watchful eye on the storm. Claudette packing little to no punch, a wind event in places like Pensacola, and some serious rain in places like Panama City and Destin, even causing minor street flooding. Vacation hotspots for people living in southeast Louisiana. This woman trying to capture it all on video.
Well, I guess it's a good thing for Pensacola. We would have liked to have seen a little more waves, but we'll take what we can get.
And the surfers taking full advantage.
We don't like all the destruction and stuff, but we do like the waves. So.
The Pensacola Beach area took a direct hit 5 years ago in September of 2004 by Hurricane Ivan. If you look around Pensacola Beach, they've completely rebuilt from that storm, and a lot of business people say they don't need another one anytime soon. Reporting on your side in Pensacola Beach, I'm Travers Mackel, WDSU News Channel 6. So